Hey guys, Dr. J here. In the previous episode, we continued going through Emporia, still trying to find a way to Comstock's house. Eventually, we reached the Grand Central Station. On the way there, Elizabeth figured out that the strange couple following us around are Robert and Rosalind Lutes, the two siblings that have created the technology that kept Columbia floating. We then went through the Grand Central Station and entered downtown Emporia. The way that last area ended, I was sure something bad would happen. But it seems like we've dodged the bullet, at least for now.
Vox are tearing this place apart.
Looks like there's going to be quite a big fight here. Best get ready for it. So I guess we'll have to ride the skyline. Problem is, I didn't see a lot of places we can take cover. Maybe just keep riding the rails while killing as much enemies as possible? Well, let's jump on it and take a better look first. This here actually looks like a pretty good place to snipe them from. We can fire at the enemies down below and can easily take cover from the ones on the second floor. As long as there aren't enemies on both sides of the second floor simultaneously. We've already taken care of both beasts thanks to our possession vigor, or more precisely, the after effects of the possession. There's another barge coming our way, and another beast we can kill with possession. Damn, the first spirit didn't hit him, and neither did the second. We'll have to change locations. If they get above us, they can easily kill us. Okay, from the looks of things, it seems that only the soldier and beast on the barge are active. I don't see any other enemies. Okay, well, there was one more barge, but it still shouldn't be too difficult to kill those as well. But they've already jumped on the skyline. I'll have to wait for them to come back. One of the beasts is riding the skyline towards us. And I've missed again! Finally! Okay, we should be able to stabilize now. Also, Liz found us assault files, so we should be fine even if more enemies arrive. And it certainly looks like more are coming. Of course they also have a beast on board. And of course, the spirit misses again. Okay, the second try hit him. Great. Well, we definitely need to find more sword files now. I wanna keep the handyman stunt with the murder of crows, but we definitely do not have enough sword for that. But I guess we don't have much of a choice now. Let's try to do as much damage as possible and then activate the decoy behind him. Man, I almost screwed up the scavenger hunt achievement. We're fine, I didn't buy anything, but it was a close call. And how about you start attacking the decoy, please? Great, there are even more Vox coming. At least the handyman is stuck behind this pile of whatever that is, and can't actually hit the decoy, but he's still aggroed on it. We can just take our time and finish him off now. That could have gone really badly, but we were lucky in the end. Now we just need to mop up these few stragglers and we're done with this fight. Open it. I would have preferred to just use possession on this beast, but I don't have the salt for that. We've wasted quite a lot of carbine ammo, but at least we're done now. Let's start looting this place and hopefully replenish our salts and health. Great, the handyman had a large health kit and a small salt vial. But unfortunately, the gear that he dropped is completely useless. There are some more health kits here. And I also saw a locked gate we have to check at some point. Let's go search the trash can. And actually, I think I'll start with the second floor first. Seems like it will take less time to go through than the ground floor. Let's jump on this rail and then hop on the one above it. Also, there's another locked door here. Good, we have a salt file. A burst gun and some ammo for it here. Yeah, besides this locked door, I don't think there's anything else interesting here.
All done.
Okay, nice, a voxophone and a salt file.
I had trapped the atom in mid-air. Colleagues called my Lutece field quantum levitation. But in fact, it was nothing of the sort. Magicians levitate. My atom simply failed to fall. If an atom could be suspended indefinitely, well, why not an apple? If an apple, why not a city?
And that's how Columbia was born. Well, that was one of the less interesting Rosalind Lutece recordings. We seem to be finding quite a lot of those for a while now. Yeah, I guess we're done searching the second floor, so let's finish exploring the first one as well. Here's the locked door. Oh, it's actually a story lock.
There at the shop. What you asked me to do.
Let's not discuss it.
No, what did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back, that's death, Mr. DeWitt. Or something so like it, I cannot tell the difference.
Well, I doubt we've missed anything in this first area, but in any case, it seems to me we'll be returning here anyway, so let's not worry too much about it. The Vox seem to have pretty much full control of Columbia now. Though, I have to wonder, who leads them now? Fitzroy is dead, so how do they keep their command structure going? Maybe it's Preston or Slate? We have all three types of vending machines here. Which kind of worries me. I'd rather not have another huge fight so soon. I do want to upgrade the return to sender vigor though. This can be extremely helpful considering our ammo situation. Too bad we can't get both of the upgrades since they are both very useful. I'm sure we'll be getting more money soon enough though, so it won't be too long before we buy the second upgrade as well. Now let's go up these stairs. Well, I hear some more enemies about. Is that a sniper up there?
There's
yep.
Sniper,
well, thankfully we have the carbine, so we should be able to easily kill him. Okay, that's one down, but there's at least one more. I believe we got the second one as well. But there's also a third one. Okay, obviously there were four snipers in total.
What?
How did he manage to shoot so quickly? Well, at least he's dead now. That actually went surprisingly well. Four snipers at the same time is not something that should be underestimated. We have a sniper rifle here, but I don't think we'll be swapping our weapons anytime soon. Anything else interesting? That decoy would have been very helpful against the snipers.
Those pennants. Chosen
your
favorite color.
Seems about right.
Okay, there's another locked door here. We seem to be getting quite a lot of those.
Can you open this?
All yours.
Okay, so what do we have here? Let's switch to the Bucking Bronco.
Ain't going nowhere.
Oh, come on! Where did they come from? At least they died quickly. A broken down elevator and a couple of lockpicks. Anything else? Really? Nothing? That was it? Well, that was a total waste of time. Anyways, let's continue. We'll be going down Harmony Lane. Actually, isn't this the area from the beginning? It sure seems like it. Let's try searching this shop. Okay, assault file. I don't see anything else, but let's at least search the corpses. Oh, a hand cannon and some ammo for it. And a small health kit. Nothing amazing, but at least it didn't cost us anything to come check it out. Oh, the store had a basement. I guess these guys were just chilling here? I'm pretty sure I just killed a civilian here, but then again, he would've probably been killed by the Vox anyway. Nice, there's a Voxophone here.
Tonight, the Prophet moved against his political enemies. He preaches mercy, but 40 souls lie tonight dead in unmarked graves. If a man was ever unworthy of grace, it would be my husband. But when I was beyond redemption, he offered it anyway. How can I deny forgiveness to one who with love granted it to me?
Kinda sounds like she was just trying to convince herself. Though, I have to say, it seems kind of... I don't know how to put it, but... She's okay to forgive him for killing 40 of his political enemies, but she draws the line when she assumes he cheated on her? Wait a minute, am I right? Speaking of, can you open that lock, Liz?
Can you help me out with this lock?
I'll see what I can do.
There are a lot of locked places in Emporia, but thankfully we have plenty of lockpicks. I saw you, dude. No point in hiding. Wow, he had a huge amount of health for a civilian. Let's see if he had anything interesting in the house. So far, it doesn't look too promising. Okay, I'm starting to get my hopes up. If he's hoarding something, that means that there could be something useful here. This gear is not it, though. Seriously, was that odor was here? We are having terrible luck with locked doors recently. Well, let's get going. We still have a ways to go to reach Comstock's Manor. Nothing down that way. I guess we're going up these stairs. Another mass execution. I mean, these are racist bastards, but still. Gunshots? Well, it was about time for another fight. Okay, so we have a fireman and some soldiers. Nothing particularly challenging. I think we managed to possess the fireman, so he should be able to deal with at least some of the soldiers. I'm not sure what he's doing though, he doesn't seem to be attacking anyone. Anyways, we've managed to kill a couple of soldiers quickly, and this machine gun turret should be very helpful. Well, actually, there are a lot more Vox than I thought, and they also have a motorized Patriot. Nice, we've unlocked the Mind Over Matter achievement. That's one of the more annoying ones, since the robots are so unpredictable. Case in point, the Vox are standing right there and the machine gun turret still has problems hitting him. Let's try to find some cover while the shield recharges. Yeah, I think we've killed most of the soldiers. I'm not sure what happened to the fireman. Was that the one we possessed initially, or is this another one? And the motorized Patriot has already reached us. He is in range of the turret though, so as long as we keep shocking him, it should be an easy kill. Unless, of course, the turret gets destroyed. Still, as long as we have enough salt for the shock jockey, it's an easy kill. Now let's deal with this fireman. Perfect! Again, great timing, Liz. I think the fireman is the last enemy, so as long as we manage to kill him, we're done with this fight. I wanna try to use the crane to make some skyline strikes on him, in order to save some of our ammo. Clearly that wasn't one of my best decisions. Let's just kill him with the... not the shock jockey, but the bucking bronco. Okay, we'll have to use up a bit more of our machine gun ammo, but at least he'll die. Great, unfortunately we've just 13 bullets left in the machine gun. Hopefully we'll find some in the area. Let's start looting the corpses and generally searching this place. Might as well summon the machine gun turret again, just in case more enemies appear. I seem to remember seeing some machine gun ammo down here. Yep, here it is. It's not a lot, but every little bit helps. Now let's go back up the stairs and continue searching. There's another locked door over there. I'm really hoping this time there's something worthwhile inside. Not that we're lacking lockpicks, but still.
A little help.
On it.
Nice, some more machine gun ammo. Is that blood? No, I think that's just red paint.
In front of all the men, the sergeant looked at me and said, "Your family tree shelters a teepee or two, doesn't it, son?" This lie, this calumny, it followed me all my life.
Okay, that's actually a pretty decent gear. Unfortunately, it's not as good as having an increased clip size, so we won't be using
that
it.
That day, no man truly called me comrade. It was only when I burnt the teepees with the squaws inside that they take me as one of their own. Only blood can redeem blood.
You know, I keep thinking about that dream that you had. New York on fire. Something about it.
What do you mean, Liz? Have you seen New York on fire as well? Through one of the terrors, perhaps? Let's check to see if we have enough money for the second return to sender upgrade. No, we need a bit more.
Found some money. Take this.
Oh, that was some awesome timing, Liz. Now we have enough for the second upgrade. Okay, that's perfect. We shouldn't die from now on, unless I do something stupid, of course. Activating the return to sender vigor should give us enough time to find some cover and to wait for our shield to recharge. It looks like we'll have to go up these stairs. I don't think we have anything else to do here. I will try to remember the salt file here, just in case we need it. Okay, this place looks interesting. Victory Square? There's been some heavy fighting here recently. I guess we'll have to spend some time rummaging through the corpses. Hopefully we'll find some more ammo. And indeed we have. I'm starting to feel a little bit better about our current resources. Okay, there's also a voxophone here.
This is for the miracle child. Hello. I'm sorry your mother, Lady Comstock, is dead. I think she is altogether better than mine. Since you live there, can you tell me why the tower has been closed? People say it's poor weather, then the pox, then a haunting. If it is a secret, I promise not to tell a soul. Your pen friend, Constance.
I wonder if Liz ever got those recordings.
Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock.
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Well, you sure look quite good for having died 19
your
years ago.
Do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
Yeah, well, being dead will do that to you.
Your mother's dead.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried.
What exactly are you planning to do, Liz? You wouldn't chop off your mother's hand, right? I guess Lady Comstock's mausoleum is this way. Memorial Garden sounds like the right place. There's another telescope here. We are almost done with those. Things aren't looking that great for Columbia. Well, that has nothing to do with us. Let's continue down this street. Let's take a look in this shop. some money here and a lockpick. Grabbing the money is actually quite important, since we had less than 100 silver eagles, which would mean Liz wouldn't have been able to resurrect us. Is there anything else here? Perfect, some more ammo. And there's also a safe here. We'll open it, of course.
Locked. Elizabeth?
Let me have a look.
Okay, now we have plenty of ammo.
Ready.
And with plenty of money as well. Life's good.
There's the graveyard, where my mother's buried.
I kinda feel like we've missed something. Yeah, there's a kinetoscope over there. Oh, but we've seen this one already. Okay, let's go pay Lady Comstock a visit. Should we go left or right? I think the gates on the left are closed, so we're going right, I guess.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for?
There's another salt file here.
There it is.
Okay, let's finish exploring before entering the mausoleum, or crypt, or whatever that is. There are some corpses here, and a crank gun? Looks like there's been another fight here. Okay, is there anything else interesting here? There's something shining over there. It's lockpicks. Okay, yeah, I think we're done here. Let's go to Lady Comstock's grave now. And some more corpses here. There was quite a lot of fighting in the cemetery. I guess the tombstones do offer decent cover. The lock is in a tear. That's a first. Well, this is it for today's episode. Thank you for spending your time with me, and if you have enjoyed it, please consider liking this video and subscribing to my channel. It will really help me a lot. Also, if you have any comments or suggestions, I would love to hear from you. Take care, and until next time.